Hey guys, today I'm showing off my updated NASCAR Diecast collection. I thought, since the NASCAR season will be starting very soon, actually tomorrow night with the Busch Clash at Daytona. It's February 8th right now, it'll be February 9th tomorrow when they run the Busch Clash at Daytona on the road course. So, I thought, why not show off my updated NASCAR Diecast collection as of February 2021. So, let's begin. Start off with Dale Jr.'s AC Delco car from 1999, then we got Dale Jarrett's Green Bay Packers car from 1999, the Elite, Michael Waltrip's 2001 Stars and Stripes car, Matt Kenseth's 2000 rookie car autographed, where I got autographed at that race in Oregon, Wisconsin, 2019, Matt Kenseth's 2003 Winston Cup champion car. It says Winston Cup on the back, you can kind of see it back there in the red. That's autographed too, which I got autographed in that at that race. Bobby Labonte's MLB All-Star Game car. Casey Atwood's 2001 Mountain Dew car. And Matt Kenseth's 2017 Last Ride autographed. Also, again, autographed at that Oregon-Wisconsin race. Then, those are all standards. Then we move down to the race versions. So we got Steve Park's 2001 Rockingham win. Kurt Busch's 2019 Kentucky win. Dale Sr.'s 1998 Daytona 500 win. His only Daytona 500 win. Dale Sr.'s 2000 Talladega win, his last career win before his death in 2001. Dale Jr.'s 2002 Oriole Busch Series win at Daytona. His 2010 Nationwide Wrangler win at Daytona. You know, where he won in the three car in that 2010 race. I'm happy I had that one. That's my holy grail. Moving on. Austin Dillon's 2017 Coca-Cola 600 car. Kevin Harvick's 2018 Las Vegas one car, which got cucumber because of the back window, if any of y'all remember that. I love the amount of confetti on it, and I got it during the Circle B diecast Black Friday sales, so for $35. Note, all these cars, I got them all for under $100. Like every car I bought, I've never spent triple digits on one car. I didn't get all the cars for $100, no. Moving on, we got Dale Jr.'s 2001 Pepsi 400 Daytona win. First race back at Daytona after Dale Sr. died. Rest in peace. Dale Jr.'s 2001 Dover win. The first race after 9/11. And you see I have the American flag in there because after he won the race, he was carrying an American flag around the track in his car. And I'll put the picture right here. And that was a pretty awesome moment. Moving on. Dale Jr.'s 2001 Talladega win. The No Bowl 5 win. Right there. Then we got his 2003, the Dale Earnhardt concert, Talladega win. And we got his 2004 Budweiser Born on Date Daytona 500 win. His 2004 Bristol Night Race win right here. 2006 Richmond win right there. Then we move down here. I had to have the exposure compensation on my camera on the maximum, so I know it's kind of blurry, so you can see these. That right there is Casey Kane's Click car from the Click movie. Sponsoring that movie. I love that movie. I actually have it on DVD. And I'm a guy who loves Adam Sandler movies. So I had to really get that one when I heard that car existed. Got Tyler Reddick's 2018 Xfinity win. That's the Homestead one with the completely blown out side after he destroyed the side with the burnout. Chase Elliott's 2019 Talladega win, Little Caesars car. Chase Elliott's 2019 Roval win, which I showed off in the last Roval reaction in 2020. Chase Elliott's 2020 Kelley Blue Book car that he won at Charlotte with. Finally ended the curse of him not winning all season. Noah Gregson's Plan B Sales Bristol win, which I said I was going to get. I was going to pre-order it, and I ended up pre-ordering it. Now I have it, so yeah. Now right there is Tony Stewart's 2009 Kansas win, Office Depot. Then we got Tony Stewart's 2012 Coke Zero 400 win at Daytona. So, then next we got Tony Stewart's 2016 Sonoma win, his final career win. I got that for a good price. Usually they sell for a lot, but I got mine for 56, which is awesome. Michael Waltrip's 2001 Talladega win, and then his 2003 Daytona 500 win right there. I'm sad they didn't make his Talladega wins. Ross Chastain's 2019 Daytona win, Xfinity win for Colleague Racing. We got Matt Kenseth's 2007 Nano Homestead black with the yellow stripe. I love that scheme. See, DeWalt Nano, it says right there. That's what it is. Then you got his 2009 Daytona 500 win. I'm still looking for the 2012 Daytona 500 win. It's Ricky Stenhouse Jr.'s Talladega win, his first career win, right there. If y'all remember that race. Then down here, right there, it's kind of hard to see, but it's Ricky Stenhouse Jr.'s 2017 Coke Zero 400 win at Daytona, his second win after the Talladega win. Then you got Tony Stewart's 2002 Atlanta win, Tony Stewart's 2003 Pocono win, Tony Stewart's 2007 Chicagoland win, Matt Kenseth's last win at Phoenix 2017, Spencer Boyd's Talladega win, in which Spencer Boyd won after Johnny Sauter was penalized for pushing Riley Herb underneath the yellow line in Talladega on that last lap. Got Trevor Bayne's 2011 Daytona 500 win, and I gotta say the famous line, you know I gotta, from DW, "Happy birthday, Trevor Bayne, 20 years old." Still one of my favorite calls of all time. Jeff Gordon's 2009 Texas win. Then we got Jeff Gordon's 2011 Phoenix win. Chase Elliott's 2020 Bounty Hunter truck, which he won against Kyle Busch to get that $100,000 bounty with iRacing on the truck, if you remember. Kevin Harvick's first win at Atlanta, 2001. Kevin Harvick's 2007 Daytona 500 win. Got his 2007 All-Star win. Got Ryan Newman's 2017 Phoenix win. Tony Stewart's 2005 Mr. Clean car, which he won in the Busch Series race at Daytona. Right there we got Elliott Sadler's 2004, the Daytona Special car, which is all silver M&M's car. I know it's kind of hard to see, it's kind of dark, but yeah, that's that one. Got Elliott Sadler's 2004 Texas win. Kurt Busch's 2017 Daytona 500 win, if y'all remember that race. Cole Custer's, his Kentucky win, his first career win. Got Kyle Larson's, 2017 Michigan Cars 3 win. Remember that, race? I went and seen Cars 3 later that night, and I had a good time at the movie theater watching it, so that was such a special moment for me, and I had to get the diecast. Alex Bowman's, first Xfinity win, Charlotte 2017. Ross Chastain's first truck series win with the truck at Kansas, the Paul Jr. Designs truck. Got Jimmy Johnson's first win, his 2002 California win, his first win. So then we got his 2004 Atlanta, always in our hearts car, when he won in Atlanta after the tragedy of the plane crash that took multiple members of Hendrick Motorsports. Timmy Hill's iRacing Pro Invitational Series win from Texas, when they did the Pro Invitational Series last year, where he won at Texas, which is an awesome thing to watch. Dale Jr.'s number 81, that was the Busch Series win at Bristol in 2004, in which he swept the weekend with the Bristol Cup win that I showed earlier in the video. Then we got his 2014 Daytona 500 win, which is, I love having. We got his, that's his 2015 Coke Zero 400 win, if you remember, with the Austin Dillon flying into the catch fence at the end of that race. Got Alex Bowman's first career win at Chicagoland against Kyle Larson right there. And then we got his Auto Club win from last season, 2020, when he won Auto Club. It's Carl Edwards' Kellogg's Bristol car win car from 2013 with Tony the Tiger on the hood. I know you can't really see it. So yeah, that's my diecast collection. Yeah, I got a lot of diecasts here. I'm excited for the new NASCAR season to start, and I thought, why not start the season with a updated NASCAR diecast collection show off. If you guys like my NASCAR diecast collection, leave a like, subscribe if you enjoy my content, and comment down below what you thought about this huge collection of diecasts. All right, bye guys.